Okay, thank you so much for being with me today. My name is Lisa Fitch. I'm a user researcher, been in the Boston area doing user research for about 15 years now, and I'm looking forward to doing this presentation for you today. The presentation is called 8 Ways That User Research Mirrors Hamilton the Musical. So I think because we're going to be talking about Broadway, just kidding. I am not going to be singing for you today, but I do encourage you to check out the music from Hamilton and the play itself when you get a chance. It's great, great fun. So what I'm going to do now is switch over to the presentation deck that I have to share with you, and let's get started. Okay, so 8 ways that user research mirrors Hamilton the Musical. Today we're going to be talking about research through that lens of Broadway. First, what I'd like to do is share a little bit about what Hamilton is, in case you're not familiar. It's a Broadway play written by Lin-Manuel Miranda, and he is the first actor to play the title role on Broadway. It's expertly written, filled with wordplay, humor, facts about history. It's very, very engaging, even to those who Broadway does not appeal. So the play packs so many lyrics, this is just a little fun tidbit, into the show that if Hamilton were to run at the cadence of a typical Broadway play, the 3.5-hour play would actually run for 6 hours. And unlike a lot of styles of Broadway musicals, Lin-Manuel Miranda said that for many reasons, including its speed, hip hop and rap were the music styles that would fit with the feel, pace and volume of words in the show. Okay. All right, so to get started, this is the first way that Hamilton, the musical, mirrors user research, recruiting actors and recruiting participants. In Hamilton, Miranda broke new ground when he cast actors of various ethnicities to play all white characters who, given that, have historically been played by white actors. So he chose to have this ethnically diverse cast to celebrate the variety of the American people today and to give Black, Latino, and Asian actors greater visibility. In user research, similarly, researchers use recruiting criteria to screen for user behaviors. And so user behaviors span across different races, incomes, family structures, education levels. So we screen for this variation in our participant samples. Like Hamilton, we want to see that diversity. We ensure that all potential types of customers and end users are represented in research. Number 2, the 10 dual commandments. That was one of the songs in Hamilton. In Hamilton, during the era of Hamilton's life, if you need to work out a dispute with another person, you head right to the dueling ground. You follow very strict processes of how to duel. So in user research, we are much more passive than those on the dueling ground. But given that, we do also follow strict processes from recruiting to data collection and analysis methods to ensure that our data is absolute fact and not opinion. So we can kind of think of it as our data commandments. Number 3, in the room where it happens. So in Hamilton, Aaron Burr struggled, here he is right in the middle there in that picture, struggled with not being included in big decisions as the government was getting set up. He sings, "I want to be in the room where it happens." Well, in user research, researchers are so lucky to get to speak directly to our customers in person, most often, to learn what is important to them, what we're trying to achieve, what issues they're having with the tools they use, and so on. So we are in the room where it happens with our customers. And during pandemics, we are in the Zoom where it happens. Number 4, young, scrappy, and hungry. In Hamilton, a bunch of, and this is part of the lyrics to one of the opening songs, revolutionary manumission abolitionists who started our country refer to themselves as young, scrappy, and hungry. They were passionate about creating a country that they wanted to live in. There they are singing about it. And in user research, all the research groups that I have been a part of or worked with in my career had this same kind of air of being young, scrappy, and hungry. And in terms of the word young, I'm not referring to age, although I will always be 29 if asked. Research groups are often at least newly evolved. There's a young quality to them, given our changing industry and product development and changing needs of any company that we're working with and evolving with. So they're often very small, these groups, and therefore have to be very efficient and scrappy. And we are hungry to make a difference for our customers and companies, often a very passionate group of people. So both young, scrappy, and hungry. Number five, history has its eyes on you. So in Hamilton, the characters in the play are aware that their actions are not happening in silos. It's all being recorded and referenced at a later time. George Washington, so right here holding the sword, sings a song which calls this out. He says, history has its eyes on you, meaning these things are going to be remembered, whatever actions you take. So in user research, our work is similarly not forgotten. It's leveraged over time. So I do, the kind of research that I do spans very fuzzy front-end foundational research all the way to very specific task-based usability testing. But often in a lot of the foundational research, we can see that while behaviors will change due to new tools that a customer, you know, acquire, for example, their deep set motivations and drivers, the things that make them want to engage with something or things that they want to achieve, are not quick to change. And so therefore our work, our research can really be leveraged over and over again and used as secondary research, for example, for new projects later. Number six, who tells our story? So in Hamilton, given Hamilton's untimely death as a man in his 40s, that's not a spoiler, by the way, of the play, that's just history. the play explores the idea that we are not able to determine how our own life stories are told after our lives are over because we're not there to tell them. So this is sort of a loose translation, loosely translated. In user research, researchers tell those stories of customers after our customers leave our interviews. And we bring the customer closer to the company that we're working with by creating a channel of communication. We're responsible to relay all that we can about our customers and to the companies that we work for and with. They'll tell the story of tonight, number seven. So again, this is lyrics from Hamilton. In Hamilton, in the beginning of the play, those who later became known as the founding fathers, they're raising their glass to a toast in this picture, discussed what it would take for them to actually fight for independence from England. And they marked that occasion as a real defining moment in the start of the American Revolution. And they noted in song, of course, because it's Broadway, that those in the future will tell the story of tonight. Well, user researchers take all the data collected from interviews, surveys, and past studies and turn them into actionable insights. And these insights are shared with product teams and stakeholders. One of the most effective ways to share findings is via storytelling. And lastly, number eight, we're looking for a mind at work. In Hamilton, Angelica Schuyler, right in the middle here, is the daughter of a wealthy senator. And she was very well educated and very interested in staying informed on the American Revolution. And while she knew her family role was to marry a wealthy man, she wanted to look for someone who was well-read and a big thinker too. So when she was introduced in the play, she comes in for the opening song. She summarized that desire as looking for a mind at work. And in user research, we feel the same way. We love working with stakeholders and partners who are passionate about including user needs in the whole process, design, all the way to development. And we are always looking for advocates of user-centered design and user research. And we're thrilled to discuss these topics with our partners. Okay, so thank you so much for coming on this little journey with me around user research and Hamilton. And I have some links here to stay connected both at LinkedIn as well as Instagram. And I included my Instagram because I know that the subject of I know that the subject of this, the theme of this conference is the idea of curiosity. And I have a lot of hobbies and things that really interest me that I devote some time to. And I use those hobbies and the things that I'm curious with and explore gardening and arts in coming up with inspiration for storytelling methods, analysis approaches, all different things kind of that I pull from that related to user research. So if you want to see more where I pull that inspiration from, you can check out my Instagram page here. And just given that it's also related to Hamilton, you'll also find there a Halloween costume that I made of Alexander Hamilton for my toddler. So again, thank you so much for coming with me on this journey, and I hope you have a great rest of your day. Bye-bye.